More graphic, dramatic, and accusing testimony today in the trial of one of two men accused of murder.
Jeffrey Mundt spent another full day saying his ex-boyfriend, Joseph Banis, is the man responsible for the killing of 37-year-old James Carroll in December of 2009. But Mundt admits to helping to bury the body in the basement of their old Louisville home, where it was found 6 months later. Eric King is live outside the Judicial Center with the very latest. Eric?
Hey, Joseph Banis' defense attorney hammered into Jeffrey Mundt all day long, but at times his line of questioning was about as erratic as today's weather. We go from one topic to another topic. At the end of the day, his goal is to try to prove that Jeffrey Mundt cannot be trusted in front of the jury. Jeffrey Mundt lied multiple times to police. That he admits. But he's adamant that his hours and hours of court testimony is the whole truth. He says his lies and silence for the 6 months James Carroll's body lied buried and decomposing in his basement were the result of fear of his boyfriend at the time, Joseph Banis.
I lived in fear of Mr. Banis. Yes, I did.
Mundt says it was Banis who killed James Carroll, but says fear for his own life prevented him from going to police.
Now you want the jury to believe that Mr. Banis is not only this one-man terror, but he has a group of associates that he runs around with terrorizing people like yourself. Is that what you're asking the jury to believe?
That's not the statement I made, no, sir.
Well, then tell us what you mean by associates.
Mr. Banis's threat, as I stated yesterday, was he would kill me, my cats, and my family if I ever crossed him. He said if he couldn't get to me, he knew people who could.
But Darren Wolf, the attorney for Banis, doesn't buy it. He points to a series of text messages from Mundt to Banis months after the murder showing certain terms of endearment and nicknames.
It was a pet term that was used between the two of us because fierce, wild, jungle puppy, puppies go grr.
Wolf says that's not the behavior of a man living in fear of another. Mundt maintains his fears, saying they came true.
It played out exactly as he threatened, yes.
Okay. Which was to turn you in and frame you for all of this, right? He framed
yes.
you for this. You
have for stated, the murder, yes.
You have stated repeatedly...
I did not murder Mr. Carroll.
You were framed, right?
The murder, yes, sir.
So clearly there are a lot of salacious details in this trial, but we should remember at its core, this is a murder trial. Somebody here was killed. The court has one responsibility here, and that's to find out who did it, and to prove that beyond a reasonable doubt. Jeffrey Mundt is now off the stand. Keep in mind, this is Banis' trial. He's the one who's on trial here for murder. The court will now move toward getting him on the stand as we move forward in this case. We're live downtown this evening. I'm Eric King, WLKY News.